Hello, everyone. Welcome to All Ears English on YouTube. My name is Jessica Beck. I am part of the All Ears English team. In this episode, you are going to hear Michelle and Lindsay discussing working from home. Guys, you have to stay up to date on business trends like this if you're going to have conversations with coworkers and managers for that matter. So guys, listen up and prepare to be confident discussing this professional topic. All right, guys, remember, if you want to find out what your level of business English is, are you entry or executive? Go to allearsenglish.com/work quiz. Take a short quiz, get your level and free resources. allearsenglish.com/work quiz. All right, let's listen.
This is an All Ears English podcast, episode 1462. Is the office dead?
Welcome to the All Ears English podcast, downloaded more than 150 million times. Are you feeling stuck with your English? We'll show you how to become fearless and fluent by focusing on connection, not perfection, with your American hosts, Lindsay McMahon, the English adventurer, and Michelle Kaplan, the New York radio girl, coming to you from Colorado and New York City, USA. And to get your transcripts delivered by email every week, go to allearsenglish.com/subscribe. Today, we weigh in on the topic of working from home. Is this the beginning of the end of the traditional office? We debate the future of work in this episode today.
Hey, Lindsay, how are you?
Doing awesome, Michelle. How are you doing today? What's up?
I'm good. Yeah. So, Lindsay, you always work from home.
Yeah. So. I've been working from home since the days I was in grad school, I guess, since I lived in Boston, 2010.
Yeah. Do you ever, like, if you had, you know, your dream world, would you keep on working from home always? Or do you wish that you could sometimes go into an office?
Oh my gosh. My dream world would be that maybe once, maybe twice a week, I could just like kind of teleport and be in a city with all of you guys,
yeah,
all four of us together, and we could rent a room in a work bar and just work together once, maybe twice a week or a day and a half a week. And then we know our goals together. We have some nice team time, have a beer at the end of the day together, and then go home and do our work in a more, honestly, a low cost way, because running a company, it's a lot cheaper to work from home, right? Rather than renting an office. But I do sometimes miss that togetherness. And sometimes I'm working on a project and it would be so easy just to tap one of each other on the shoulder and just ask someone's opinion. But instead we have to make a time to get on Skype, make an appointment.
Right.
That part is hard.
Right. No, that's a good point. No, I know. I would love that too. It would be so much fun. And like, you know, also because a lot of organic ideas just come from being around each other. So like, unfortunately, we don't have that aspect, but so many people don't have that right now because most everybody is working from home.
For sure. Yeah. I mean, I assume that this is going to change as we come out of coronavirus and find a vaccine. But I don't know, because I have heard some friends of mine, their friends are saying that their companies are selling their office space permanently.
Really?
Yes. Permanently out of the office, like permanently working from home, because they're realizing that they don't actually need it.
Yeah. But you know what? I wonder if that's going to backfire one day. I do think that there has to be some combination. Like you said, I mean, I think that we do a good job of, you know, trying, like, you know, we do different things to try and, you know, do team building and things like that. But it's, you know, certainly if we were in an office at least a little bit, you know, there would be, I wonder what it would be like. You know, I'm sure some things would be different, some things would be the same, but it would certainly be interesting.
It'd be great. That would be an ideal world. And it's smart too, because you don't have to, you know, you don't have to permanently rent a space. But that's why these work bars have started to become more popular. WeWork and Work Bar and all these brands where you can rent a desk or rent an office for a team for an hour or a day or whatever it is. Yeah.
So, all right. Well, we're going to be talking more about working from home today, since so many people are dealing with this. Because I found an interesting survey from, it was a HuffPost YouGov survey, and we will give you guys the link. So the article is on HuffPost.com, and it's titled, "Many workers would prefer to keep working from home at least some of the time." And then It says, "Most people working from home due to their coronavirus wouldn't be disappointed if the change were permanent." This is by Monica Torres and Ariel Edwards Levy, and it was from May 26th and May 27th, 2020. So we're going to talk about this today.
Okay. Yeah, this is really interesting. I mean, the other piece of this is also autonomy, which is really important to people. And also, you know, because people's kids are home, people need the chance to kind of blend work and life together a little more, which is harder to do when you're in the office, right? Yeah. And even if our kids aren't at home, right, even if coronavirus were not happening, I think it's healthy to be at home and to be able to say, I'm going to work for an hour, then I'm going to go for a jog, take my dog out, come back, work, to create our own schedules. I do think that's healthy.
I think so too. I think there's a lot to be said about all of us trying to box ourselves into a 9-to-5 schedule. And that's good for some people, but not good for others. And, you know, to try and say like everybody is uniform in that way, you start at this time, you end at this time or whatever, it may not be playing to everyone's strengths.
Right. I mean, we know for you, Michelle, you're not a morning person.
Right.
So if we had an office in New York and you had to come in at 7:30, you would struggle for the first hour and a half, right?
Yeah. Well, this is a whole conversation for another day. Actually, my mom was just telling me about the book she's been reading about sleep and how, you know, how certain people don't fit into the normal, you know, like somebody like me who I would prefer to sleep at different hours. You know, some people are kind of at a disadvantage because it's through no fault of their own, they're follow a certain schedule.
Yeah, for sure.
So but that's a whole other conversation we should definitely do sometime. So, I agree. There are definitely benefits to working from home. So in this survey, there's a ton of questions, but the one that we're going to talk about today is, and guys, I'm going to be quoting a little bit just to give you some of the results, and then we're going to be giving you our own spin on it. So, so the article says, the question is, if it were up to you and coronavirus were no longer a concern, which would you prefer? So, 15% of people said that they would want to always be working at home. So 15%. So whereas 23% said they'd kind of like a mix, right? Yeah. So some days at home and some days in an office or another place where they can get work done.
Yeah, that makes total sense.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And then 16% of the people said they would always want to be in an office or some workspace. Five percent of the people weren't sure. And then 41%, that's a lot. So the question does not apply to me. Anyway, you can see that, you know, aside from that answer, the highest one is that people do kind of want this mix.
Yeah.
So which I thought was so interesting. And like I said, guys, there are other questions on the survey. You can check it out. We'll give you the list. But we're going to be focusing on this question for today. And I mean, Lindsay, so you said this is not surprising to you.
No, I would have thought it would be even higher than 23% that would want the mix. I mean, the mix just makes a lot of sense. I think when you mix things up, you get a little variety. You know, it's I also think that this kind of coincides with like the way that now people are just looking for more meaning in their work, in their day-to-day work, in the work they do, and then how they spend the day-to-day work tasks. Mm-hmm. They want meaning. They want it to mean something. And so there's kind of a movement, I feel like, in the way people are thinking about work. And it makes sense that it would coincide with this idea that people are moving away from the typical 9-to-5 where we have to be a different person at work versus outside of work. Guys, something exciting is coming soon when we're going to help you learn how to fully understand fast group English conversations, but you have to get on the list to be invited. Go to allearsenglish.com/group to get on the exclusive invitation list. Go to allearsenglish.com/group.
Right. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. I mean, one of the key words I would say for today is hybrid, because that's this word. I mean, it's coming up a lot now for work, for school, this hybrid model. So a hybrid is kind of like a mix, right?
Yes.
So you could say, oh, I like a hybrid. I want to be a little bit at work. I want to be a little bit at home.
Yeah, exactly. And you kind of have that. Well, you had that before.
I did.
Michelle, what were you doing before? What was your mix?
Oh, I was going into school. Depending on the semester, but before this all started, I was going like for two pretty full days, going to an office, going into school, and then doing the rest of the work during naps and at night, you know, doing all ears English and things like that. So mm-hmm. I did have this mix, and I really liked it. I truly miss going and seeing people and meeting with students in person. I had a pretty nice mix going, and hopefully at some point I can get back to it. But I definitely miss it for sure.
Yeah, for sure. I totally get that. I definitely, when I stopped working with students in person, I also missed it right away. And sometimes I'm like, oh my gosh, when am I going to see someone again?
Oh my gosh. Yeah. I know. I think about that too. I mean, so it's also with teaching, it's definitely different to do it online. I mean, it's just different, but you know, there are ways to build rapport as well. So I'm still getting used to it, but you know, there are benefits to it as well. But I do miss being with people in person. But you know, there are a lot of benefits of working from home. Or Lindsay, when people write working from home, sometimes they write it, have you ever seen somebody write it WFH?
Yes, definitely. That's an important acronym. I'm not sure if we cover that in our business course or not, but it should be in there if it's not, guys. So a lot of people might write in an email, they might say, I am WFH tomorrow. I've seen that in the corporate world, right? Telling their colleague they're not coming into the office the next day. So watch out for that acronym, guys. WFH. Yes.
Yes, for sure. That's a key for today. So I mean, to work from home, I mean, it's definitely more flexible. No commute. That's huge. I mean, although I have heard of like some workplaces, I haven't experienced this, but I've heard of some workplaces that are like actually starting earlier and doing meetings when people would have normally been commuting.
Oh yeah. But are they finishing earlier or just extending?
I don't know. I just have heard, I saw a headline about that somewhere and I was like, oh man, that kind of stinks.
I personally love not having a commute. I mean, I think it's great. If I could walk to my work, it'd be fine. But getting in a car and driving, no.
Yeah.
Not doing it. Oh man, what a time suck, right? I mean, hopefully our listeners get to listen to All Ears English on the way to work.
Yeah, exactly. So you can find things that you like. Dan has a long commute to work, so it is terrible.
No.
But I mean, also working from home, you have your own space. You can kind of set up your own little area, and then you know, for now, obviously, that's the safest thing because of the virus. But you know, then there are negatives of working from home too. I mean, I think, you know, your eyes can sometimes hurt from video chatting so much, from Zooming or whatever you're on.
For sure. I find that at the end of the day, I have to get outside, get to the park, get out of my office. You know what I mean? Because work can really take over your life if you're not careful when you work from home. So.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Right. It's that feeling of when does work start and when does work end. It's different.
Yeah.
I have trouble with that sometimes of just being like, okay, no, I'm not going to. Because if I know that I have to do something and I can do it in that moment, even if it's a time when I shouldn't be working, I can't stop myself from doing it. It's like, I'm like, okay, I'm doing it now.
I know what you mean. That comes back to, as we said last week, that task mentality that we have in the United States, right? Just to get stuff done, cross it off. It feels so good. Yeah, it's really interesting. I think that's very cultural. And also you have a good work ethic. It's hard because it's almost like people working from home, if they have a good work ethic, it's almost dangerous in some ways, right? Because they have a hard time setting boundaries and just saying, I'm not working anymore. I mean, It's tricky.
But you have to kind of find the balance. I mean, then of course, you know, a negative is missing out on the human connection, like you said, and you know, the collaboration that we talked about earlier on. So, you know, that's why I think, since it is so many positives and so many negatives, like of working from home, I think this hybrid is definitely like the ideal, but I don't know. So, I mean, Lindsay, predictions, you think this is the end of the office?
Good question. I think it might be the beginning of the end of the traditional office, where companies rent massive buildings, corporate space in large cities. But I don't know if it's the beginning of the end of people coming together to work physically. Do you know what I mean? I think companies might start looking to have their corporate headquarters like maybe more spaced out in the suburbs in a cheaper space, or different setups, or renting space and co-working spaces. They might start to get more strategic about, do they actually need that huge office building in Midtown?
Yeah. Midtown, but then what's going to happen in those buildings?
That's an important question, Michelle, which I think we should do another episode on. I've been reading some stuff about New York City, like what's going on in the city right now. Yeah. I had heard that the business leaders, those business leaders, right, of those corporate companies approaching de Blasio, right, the mayor, and saying, hey, we are worried about this city because they're worried the tax base is going to go down. That it, I don't know. You're in New York. I'm not. You have to give us the update of how the streets look these days.
yeah, definitely. We'll have to do a New York episode one of these days soon, for sure. Lots to talk about.
A lot to talk about there. I am concerned about New York. So I think it might be the beginning of the end of like the typical, let's get in the car, drive to work an hour, stay there 9 to 5, and then go home. I think it might be the beginning of the end of that style.
Yeah, hopefully at least people can have more flexibility now. Like even once we go back to regular life, hopefully, you know, it is, hopefully it is easier to say, okay, I'm working from home today, you know.
Yeah.
I don't know, for whatever reason.
I think it will become. And then let's just quickly review a couple of vocabs today that we gave our listeners, right? We have the WFH. Again,
work,
guys,
from
that means
home.
Mm-hmm. And do people say that? Have you heard people say the acronyms, or
no.
would they say, yeah,
W?
Right, I haven't, no, not really. No. Mostly just in emails, writing it, guys. Yeah, okay. Yeah, acronyms are mostly to be written generally.
Yeah. So, actually, I think we did an episode on that. You guys will have to search for that one.
Okay.
And then also another way to say that you're working from home is you're teleworking or telecommuting.
Yeah. Okay. And then working remotely for me is the more common one. And this could also mean that you are going to go start your weekend early and work from that place.
Right.
There are
people that
do that too.
And then last one is home office. You know, I'm in the home office today.
In my home office. Yeah, for sure. For sure. So good. I mean, Michelle, our business English course that we created this past summer, it's all about this stuff, like those skills that our listeners now need more than ever, right? I mean, what are the skills that we work on in there?
Oh, yeah. Well, we do video calls, phone calls. Wait, we have templates, lots of different things on with slides. So much that you can get over there to really get into this working from home feel, and also, you know, going in, you know, we cover it all. So get that at allearsenglish.com/business.
Yeah, I love it. Guys, you've been asking for a business English course for years. We finally built it for you. It's based on native vocabulary from more than 100 people that we surveyed. They told us what vocabulary they use every day, right? We didn't take these from textbooks or ESL lists online. We took it from our surveys. So go and grab that course. Again, it's allearsenglish.com/business. So Michelle, what do we want to leave our listeners with then today?
Okay. Well, guys, you know, let us know. Are you working from home? Do you like it? Would you like to do one? Would you like to do the other? Or would you like to have a permanent hybrid? So we can talk more about this in the future, but we need your comments to get more of this conversation going. So definitely comment and let us know.
Yeah. And I think we'll have to do a follow-up to this once we have some real research out. I feel like once we get into 2021, you know, employers will have some actual numbers and research on productivity and what they think, like their opinions on how has it gone. Having, because I know like the big tech companies like Google, and like, those guys are working from home until like 2021 or something.
Yeah.
Right. So, so we're going to get some real data and come back to this topic soon, guys.
All right, Lindsay. Well, this has been fun, guys. Have a good one. And wherever you're working, I hope you enjoy.
Sounds good, Michelle. Take care.
All right, bye. Bye.
Thanks for listening to All Ears English. If you are taking IELTS this year, get your estimated band score with our 2-minute quiz. Go to allearsenglish.com/myscore. And if you believe in connection, not perfection, then hit subscribe now to make sure you don't miss anything. See you next time.